name is Andrew Hudson. I'm the head of the Ocean and Water Governance Program at the United Nations Development Program based in New York. So over the roughly the 1980s and 1990s, a lot of ocean scientists around the world, but driven and coordinated in part by the U.S. National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, conducted an exercise of identifying and sort of categorizing a suite of what ended up being 64 what are called large marine ecosystems, or LMEs, around the world. And these mostly blanket the continents of the world, North America, Latin America, Africa, Asia, etc. And these LMEs are each characterized by certain physical, chemical, biological, geological characteristics that in some ways separate them from the rest of the ocean, and they can be treated as sort of discrete biogeographic units. And that's become very useful within a management framework, because LMEs have increasingly been recognized as an appropriate scale and framework within which marine resources can be and should be managed. And so one of the other results of this analysis was the recognition that the large majority of these large marine ecosystems around the world are shared. Their boundaries are shared by two, or in some cases many, countries, as many as 24, for example, in the case of the Caribbean Sea large marine ecosystem. So this was a second aspect that underscored that to move to effective, sustainable use and management of these marine ecosystems required a multi-country approach, that is transboundary cooperation. And the Global Environment Facility, which came into being in the early 1990s, within the first few years recognized LMEs as a important and relevant biogeographic management unit for marine ecosystem management at a transboundary scale. And so basically back in 1995, the GEF first codified LMEs as the appropriate management unit for GEF financial support for implementing these programs.